graduates as their names are being read. Graduation symbolizes the start of a bright future for our young people as they move forward in life prepared with their MPS education. What's next for each graduate? The sky is the limit. Our graduates today are headed to college, technical school, apprenticeships, the military, and the world of opportunities. Each graduate today will receive an MPS alumni pin to wear with pride and to carry with them as a fun reminder of their experiences and accomplishments in Milwaukee Public Schools. Family and friends, thank you for being the support and encouragement that our seniors needed to get them to this point. Today, we celebrate the graduates, but also you, the community of family and friends that have supported them. I would extend a debt of gratitude to the teachers, staff, and administration who have worked to build up the young people, preparing them to go forward to face the world. Because of the dedicated MPS staff, the loving families, and support systems at home, these young adults today are completing high school and stand prepared to move forward in their next stage of life. I ask you to take time to review the impressive scholarships earned by the class of 2023 that is printed in your program. Graduates, I congratulate each one of you on your accomplishments today. I encourage you all to make this the first of many milestones to come as you continue your journey. To our audience, thank you for being here to support our graduates. I will now ask you to please stand to welcome the class of 2023. Thank you.
Welcome, everyone. Thank you for joining us this morning on this glorious occasion. If we could please remain standing for our national anthem at this time. If you are able, please stand, remove your hats for the Pledge of Allegiance at this time. I'm sorry, the national anthem at this time. Thank you, and now I'd like to bring our scholar, Hayden Howe, to the podium to lead us in the national anthem and Pledge of Allegiance. The Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, scholars. You may be seated. At this time, I would like to bring scholar Noah Buendia to the stage, who will do our valedictorian speech. Followed by that, I will return to this podium and greet you on behalf of Milwaukee Public Schools.
Good morning, scholars, mentors, families, and friends. My name is Noah Buendia, and I am representing the Audubon High School as the graduating class of 2023's valedictorian. It is an honor here to stand on the stage today and recognize the accomplishments and opportunities the class of 2023 has taken and earned. Congratulations to all the scholars here today for all their accomplishments. When I first began looking at high schools, Audubon was my first choice, but I actually did not get accepted. However, that quickly changed, and we are here today. Many of my mentors throughout life have taught me lifelong lessons that I will carry with me. The three most important ones are: one, never give up on what you want in life; two, the ability to ask for help; and three, meet as many people from all areas of life and learn from them. I was so scared I was not going to be able to get the education I needed to be successful in life. But through opportunities offered to me at Audubon, I'm on the right path to be the best version of myself. I was fortunate enough this year to be nominated as the Youth of the Year to represent the Audubon Boys and Girls Club. Although I was runner-up for the city, this opportunity has afforded me to give back to my community and be an example for those to come behind me. With being so involved with the club, along with school and sports, I became busy to the point where it wasn't healthy. Time management has always been such a big struggle for me. I love to be involved, but sometimes it was just too much. But I'm proud to have been able to learn time management skills and remain impactful in my activities. Audubon not only gave me a safe space to learn, but an access to a healthy relationship with my own time. The connections I have made have given me the opportunity to go to my top choice university, University of Wisconsin-Madison, on a full ride scholarship. I truly could not have done it without any of my family and all my mentors I've had through high school and the Boys and Girls Club, so thank you. Even with all that invaluable help, I'm nervous to take this huge step. The organizations I am in and Audubon have exposed me to an abundance of opportunities that will help me be more successful throughout my college career. They have given me the opportunity to have amazing relationships that I intend to have for a lifetime. Class of 2023, we are the class and generation that will make the future happen. Today truly is a special day. We aren't just graduating from high school. We're moving in a new direction. We're starting our future. I'm proud of each and every one of my fellow scholars here today. I'm urging you all to remember this day, to remember the triumph you are feeling right now as you go through the difficulties of college, careers, and life. There's a sign right outside the Ready Center where I went for many scholarship workshops, and I love to read it every time I came in. The sign states, "It will take time. It will require dedication. It will require willpower. You will need to make healthy decisions. It requires sacrifice. You'll need to push your body to the max. There will be temptation, but I promise you this, when you reach the goal, it will have been worth it. Your goals may be difficult, and that is a good sign. You should not have an easy time doing something that will have such a drastic impact on your life. Make sure you have that one goal that may be hard to obtain, but something you strive for each and every day. Everyone in this room is so talented, and I know you all do great things in life. We're all examples to everyone of what is possible, so continue to be the phenomenal students and people that you are. Thank you.
Excellent job, Scholar Noah. I went a little off script this morning. Typically, we try to greet you on behalf of Milwaukee Public Schools initially. But I know our superintendent, Dr. Keith Posley, who I will introduce very, very shortly, has always said his children first. And so allowing Noah to share that story on behalf of a valedictorian to be able to see and show us that MPS is always proud and it resonates through all of our students. So again, we appreciate you, Noah, in regards to sharing those scholarly words to us and how your journey will move forward with continued success of Milwaukee Public Schools. So although we have started our program, I would like to extend a special welcome at this time to all of our distinguished guests. Please join me in welcoming them as they stand to be recognized when their names are called. Dr. Keith Posley, Superintendent of Milwaukee Public Schools. Dr. Catrice Cotton, Chief School Administrator's Officer. In our gallery is Ms. Adria Madalini, Chief Human Resources Officer. And then we have Dr. Smith, who is our Regional Superintendent. Followed by our Instructional Learning Director, Mr. Gregory Ogumbawale. And also on behalf of our Audubon staff, who you will see kind of scattered around, our administrative staff, our phenomenal professors, our support staff, we all appreciate you for being here this morning. So I come to you with a smile this morning because typically the greeting is good morning. And the reason I say good is because this morning we can proclaim the good in the day. There are days where we greet each other and we just kind of speak of a moment in time. Morning, if you ever pay attention, people say morning, morning, morning. But this morning, there was a little bit of a proclamation on top of that, and it was good. And so as we greeted each other this morning, we made sure to emphasize the word good, because today is the day that we celebrate our scholars. Today is the day that we celebrate the journey that has taken place for now almost 13 years for some and a little beyond for others. But more importantly, today is the day that we as MPS get a chance to look at you as our scholars and say, beginning tomorrow, your S number will no longer work. Okay, we say that with love to you, but you know you always have a home. We are so proud of you at Audubon. We are so proud of you in our community. We could not have done it without you. You make us MPS proud. And so what I want to do at this time is just recognize individuals collectively, for various categories that we have bestowed upon us this morning. And so you'll see students this morning with various cords that adorn their garments this morning. And what I call your respective category, I would like for you to stand so that you could be recognized this morning. Individuals with white cords, all of scholars with white cords, please stand. These individuals have a cumulative grade point average of 4.0 to 3.5. So again, these are your scholars that have met the bar and exceeded the bar. Congratulations to you. You may be seated. The individuals and scholars who have gold cords, if you have a gold cord, please stand. These scholars represent academic excellence from the threshold of earning a 3.0 to 3.49. So once again, the bar of excellence has been exceeded. So congratulations to those scholars as well. Audubon underscores the expectation of community service, as does the Milwaukee Public Schools, because it is important that our young people understand that community represents village. There isn't anyone in this room who can do anything by themselves. And so instilling that value system in our young people through the lens of community service work, volunteering, and also, you know, sharing in community service learning projects, et cetera, is something that Audubon prides itself in. And so the following students have exceeded 100 hours of community service. Now, the district's threshold is somewhat, you know, lower than that. However, the importance of the message is every student who graduates must participate in community service. And so for the students who have red cords, please stand. Students who have red cords, please stand. These young scholars exemplify the hand held of brotherhood because they understand and know that it takes a village to raise a child. It takes a village to help us move in a direction where community can be at the forefront of our prosperity. So again, we appreciate you, and we understand and know now that you know how to go and get another person to help work on this journey towards excellence. So we appreciate you for that. You may be seated. The next individuals is really a special place for me as well, because Audubon, although we are a small high school, and I did hear a phrase that says the best things come in small packages. And so I know that the most expensive sometimes do too. But Audubon, this graduating class is of 75. And so we in comparison to some of our brothers and sisters, you know, we're a smaller group. But I want to acknowledge that NAF, which stands for National Academies Foundation, is a high school, it's a nationwide high school consortium where individuals from the community, higher education, business partners, Fortune 500 companies, they all begin to partner and network with high schools who offer a variety of academies, everything from hospitality and tourism to engineering. You may see culinary arts. These are all different academies that are adorned within Milwaukee Public Schools. And so Audubon has an Academy of Information Technology. It's in the name. And so this particular group is our very first group that has completed the NAF track certifications and are now in a position where they can have conversations with some of these Fortune 500 companies around resume writing, interview skills, skill development, and some of these other pieces that we know help them move forward. And so I want to extend a hearty congratulations to these young people, because not only have you represented Milwaukee Public Schools academically, but now you're looking at nationwide, where you get a chance to continue that work in some of these philanthropic companies who give back to our communities and make sure that the next student who sits in your seat has a better opportunity than you did. And so at this time, if I can have all of my young people who have green cords, the NAF track certification cord, please stand. Thank you. You may be seated. Finally, we know that biliteracy is something that every student aspires. And so biliteracy looks different depending on where you're from. But in Milwaukee Public Schools, there is an expectation that when you're looking at receiving a seal of biliteracy, it means that you have not only embraced a second language, but you can present it, demonstrate it in multiple venues, and in multiple modalities. And so the students who will stand at this time have received a seal of biliteracy, which basically means they're proficient in two different languages and can do that in a way where it's fluid and bring someone else in to help them when there is a need for assistance. And so at this time, I would like to ask all students who have silver cords, the seal of biliteracy cords, please stand. Thank you, and you may be seated. And before I kind of give my personal address to you, I just want to say that this collective group, as I mentioned before, is a small body, 75 students represented here. But collectively, they have earned more than $1.5 million in scholarship money. So can we make some noise for young people who understand how to go get the money? That's what we say, let's go get the bag, as the young people say. Right, so congratulations to you. $1.5 million, that is a phenomenal feat for a very small group of intellectuals, and we appreciate you for that. Correct, I appreciate that, sir. So I have been corrected. The white cords represent 4.0 to 3.5. Honor roll. Okay, so we have someone who can help us with that piece. All right, but we appreciate all students who have received those honors, and we know that you'll wear those cords proudly. Right? So on behalf of myself, Leon Gross, the principal here at Audubon Technology Communication Center, I do want to say to each and every one of you, thank you so much for allowing me to humbly serve as your school leader. It has been an 8-year journey for me, and I know that throughout the course of this time, I have learned so much, not only from my staff, from my students, but also my community partners and parents. It is an honor to be able to serve as a school principal in Milwaukee Public Schools. I also am an alumni of Milwaukee Public Schools, so I started MPS, I have stayed MPS, and I will continue to support MPS. And what I want you all to understand, that as you move forward beyond today, your journey for excellence doesn't stop. You are no longer a student, but you are forever part of the fabric of Milwaukee Public Schools. So when you walk your walk, whether it's in a community, whether it's when you begin to become a professional and employ individuals, whether you're an entrepreneur, you remember that there is a place for you when you're addressing excellence, when you're addressing partnership, when you're addressing family, when you're addressing motivation, when you're addressing inspiration, dedication, but most importantly, love. That is what we hope that we have given you through the course of your tenure and your journey in Milwaukee Public Schools. Love is the only gift that doesn't cost anything, but it's not free. You have to go and get it. You have to work for it. And so remember to keep your hand extended as you move forward, because you can't help anyone, nor can you receive, if you don't have an arm extended. That means you're giving. So give freely, give cautiously, but give caringly, because you are what make MPS proud. And as I've shared with other scholars before you, the reason that the night is illuminated on a clear night where you see stars, purposefully there are spaces between those stars, because there is a space for you to share your story and align yourself amongst the stars. I love you, and you are very powerful to me. You will always be a part of this fabric, and I want you to remember that until you are able to share this testimony with someone else. Okay? So again, I appreciate giving me an opportunity to share that on behalf of our staff at Audubon. So at this time, this is really what you've been waiting for. This is the time, to all of the parents. And scholars, before we bring you to the stage, can we stand and applaud our parents, our loved ones, who have supported us on this journey, who have stayed up countless nights, who have looked at some of those math assignments and asked the question, I don't know what this is, who have paid those fees, made sure you were here every day. We appreciate you. And at this time, what I would like to do is bring to the stage our presenter, who will call the names of the scholars. You may be seated, scholars. And then from there, follow the directions of those who will guide you to the stage and across the stage. All right? This is your moment. This is what you've been waiting for. I'm so proud of you. So at this time, if I could bring Ms. Chambers to the stage, and then we will follow the lead of the dignitaries.
Mohammed Abdul Shakur. Hayden Aiken. Rahaf Ali. Antonio Altamirano. Emmanuel Aris. Armando Benitez Ortega. Brooklyn Brown. Noah Buendia. Julio Camacho. Aiden Cram. Bryce Cram. Marilyn Cruz Perez. Jada DeBerry. Aiden Denomi. Angel Diaz. Dakota Figueroa. Michael Frank. Ililiana Garcia Ewald. Jesse Garcia Ortega. Taryn Gilo. Oscar Gomez Martinez. Eric Gonzalez. Cohen Heinzelsberger. Aaliyah Henderson. Juan Enriquez Fuentes. Valeria Hernandez Alamilla. Armando Herrera. Aliana Hicks. Jin Holland. Dante Hoover. Hayden Howe. Antonia Inman. Adriana Jensen. Francisco Jimenez. Azaria Jones. Love you. Sasha King. Victor Lowe. Ryan Lopez. Lisbeth Lopez Cordero. Moises Macias Mendoza. Jeremy Morales Aquino. Crystal Munoz. Ivalisa Nieves. Iran Orioles. Hamza Noor. Taisha Payano Desir. Hua Fan. Jimena Piedrabuena Alcaraz. Teron Rivers. Good job, Adalys Rodriguez. Samantha Rosales Alvarez. Jasmine Rubalcava. Lanaya Ruiz. Dorian Salgado. Yair Sanchez. Jamarion Sanders. Ekram Soriano. Arieli Sostre. Morgan Staub. Walter Summers. Elliot Sumner. Marissa Trevino. Roberto Utrera. Emily Valle. Jacqueline Vargas Gonzalez. George Vasquez Borda. Kiara Vasquez. Rolando Vega. Oscar Velasquez. Brian Vidal. Congratulations, everyone. I am so unbelievably proud of you all.
Can we give them up one more time for all of our Cardinal Scholars? I know we can make a little bit more noise than that. Can we give it up for our Cardinal Scholars? You did it. How does it feel? Feels great? Okay. Your time is coming. That clock is winding down. So before I turn it over to our, really the true man of the hour, because he's gonna bless you with something, all right? I just need to have a little bit of housekeeping information for the families. As we prepare to present the 2023 graduating class to you, please remain seated until the graduates have exited the stadium floor. We ask that you exit the building to meet your graduate outside on Kilbourne Avenue. We do appreciate you for doing just that and celebrating with us this morning. It means so much to us to be able to celebrate with you on behalf of your children in Milwaukee Public Schools. And so without further ado, I would like to bring the gentleman who has the key to releasing your future to the stage, Dr. Keith Posley, Superintendent of Milwaukee Public Schools.
Good morning, family, guests. We are prepared to present the class of 2023. If you would please rise, students. Graduates, please turn your tassels from right to left. By the authority vested in me, by the Wisconsin Department of Public Instruction, the Milwaukee Board of School Directors, as the Superintendent of Milwaukee Public Schools, I now declare you official graduates of the Milwaukee Public Schools. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Running through the strange life, chasing all them green lights, throwing out the shade for a little bit of sunshine, hippie with them good vibes, pictures on my phone lights, everything is so fine, little bit of sunshine.
Yeah. Crazy lately, I'm confirming, trying to rob myself of something, you just trying to get a word and life is not fair. I've been working on my tunnel vision, trying to get a new prescription, taking swings and even missing, but I don't care. Just a little bit, like life just woo. I'm making more, just a little bit. Spin a little more, take a bit of it. Smile a little more, and I'm into it. Sick of seeing all the selfies, now I don't.